Hi, this is Gemini Dhar and I have Deepak with me. But before Deepak starts talking, I want to share something about Entrepreneur XL. Entrepreneur XL is a community of 50,000 entrepreneurs across the globe. And if you see a reach, we have a reach of more than 2 lakh people. And why I'm saying this is because I've met somebody who is talented, and this is not his main core business.
Right.
He believes in building a community, and we are a community, and we know how precious it is to send out great content, to do add value to people's life, to add humor, entertainment, and we have a lot of different kinds of genres that we explore. And Deepak, it was very interesting for me to see your profile and understand how you've been amazingly into the IT industry. So he has had 25 years of experience. He's traveled across the globe, right from the scratch of not knowing anything about IT to learning to the best, and creating 7 radio stations today for his community, that is the Sindhi community. Say hi in Sindhi. I got you. Say hi in Sindhi.
We just say Jai Julelal.
Jai Julelal to all the Sindhi members who are watching, because he believes that he can add some value to his community, and he's given back in an amazing way, a digital way, which is very powerful. I'm a digital fan, I'm a podcaster, YouTuber. So I'm Gemini Dhar, and I'm going to introduce Deepak Keswani. Deepak.
Myself, I'm Deepak Keswani. Thank you so much, Gemini, for having me. It's the moment you said that we are going to have a live conversation, I was super excited. It's a great opportunity for me to share so much about what I have done with your community.
The thing is, we are going to come back to the numbers that you are, your strength is, because numbers matter. Every person listening to this live is going to take something home.
Right.
You never know, you will have a Gujarati community, there must be existence which I didn't know, but you can come and connect with us if you have radio stations for Gujarati, Marathi, Punjabi, whatever. But why a Sindhi community is so strongly connected with each other is the reason that he's contributing. And where did this all start? So I know you are a genius at your work, you do websites, you do IT stuff, you do innovative stuff. But I wanted to share that reason that you started a radio station, or you started digitally sharing the legacy of your grandfather, because I loved that story what you shared with me.
Before telling like how all that radio started, I would like to share a little bit of my past. So I came out from the middle class family. We used to stay in Ulasnagar, and there used to be a lot of struggles in life. So my grandfather used to be a great singer. He was not a singer by profession, but he was a singer by hobby. So he used to sing Sindhi kalams of Master Chandar Sahib. Master Chandar Sahib has been legendary musician, vocalist, and everybody knows in Sindhi community who's Master Chandar. My grandfather's voice used to resemble with Master Chandar Sahib. So many of the people used to ask him, can you sing Master Chandar Sahib's song? So when I used to see people so attracted to him, to his voice, and I used to listen to Master Chandar Sahib songs, so I felt, our old people in our family, they have some kind of a heritage. It can be music, it can be their learnings. We should record that. So I wanted to record his voice, his songs in the original, in the best format possible. So I was, since I was in technology, so in those days I thought of making an album for my grandfather, which is a purest music which I can record. So once I told my grandfather this is what I wanted to do, he said okay, we can take these 8 or 9 tracks. And in year, I think 1999, I recorded the entire album of my grandfather. So it was in the pure wave format, and unfortunately on internet there was no mechanism available in those days to share so huge music files. So I waited for a little of time, and the MP3 concept came, and it was flourishing everywhere. So I learned how you can convert the WAV files into MP3. It used to take, in old computers, it used to take a half hour to convert even one song. And then I was the first one in Sindhi community to share Sindhi music.
Wow.
Of my grandfather, as Sindhi music available in MP3 format, in a very lightweight format, you can download and play. And as you know, Sindhis are dispersed all across the world. I created a website and I kept all those songs on the website. So this became a mechanism to distribute Sindhi music to Sindhis.
And you share the cassettes with your community people and they loved it. And a lot of people connected with you that why don't you get our songs across. And I think you have 300 to 400 songs you got. I remember it right.
When like my grandfather's songs were downloaded more than 50,000 times. So many of the people who were the singers, they felt like, you know, we are the good singers. Why can't we be online? So they approached me. Some of the singers approached me like, can we upload our songs also? Can you upload our songs also? I said, okay, why can't we can do that? So I had, you know, so many good friends, about 20, 25 good singers who became my friends. And some of good singers I approached, okay, we have created a platform. So we have songs, we have listeners all across the globe. They can listen to your music and I can provide you this kind of the platform. They were so happy.
So, Deepak, while you were sharing your grandfather, my grandmother used to recite Gita and she used to teach Gita to the students. So, in her last days, when she was very old, we had recorded her and my father's voice. We lost my father very suddenly. So, that was the only audio note I have. But I have my grandmother's way of teaching Gita and we learned Gita from listening to the audio. So, audio is really powerful. Of course, video has no comparison because you have audio, video and all an experience. But to reach out to somebody while they are driving or to reach out to people when they are in their deep thoughts, it can be very impactful.
As life is becoming very fast, we really don't have time to look at the book and read it. So nowadays the video and audio is becoming more powerful means.
What I remember a very scary incident is most of the time my Uber and Ola drivers are watching a cricket match while driving. And that scares the hell out of me because I said you are not allowed to pick the call when you are driving, but they are very happy looking into the screen, brake, accelerator. So I think a podcast or an audio is a much safer and a much more impactful way. Music plays, you know, all the time. Mm-hmm. So I think it is very powerful, the audio medium. And you know, you were sharing with me, how did this radio station idea come out?
So you know, so many of the singers has approached me and so many albums were available online and people were downloading. You know, somehow I felt there can be something more that we can do. So in 2011, I was kind of on medical leave. So I was not able to work hard, but at least I can do something on the computer. So that is the time I thought, you know, why can't we put it in a proper package and make a radio station and make those same songs available in a streaming way. So even though people are not downloading, you know, sometimes you just want to be surprised. Okay, what's the new song? So you go to radio.
Yeah.
So can we do something like that? So one thought of FM came, but you know, FM has its own requirements and those were not feasible for our Sindhi community, which is which is spread all across the world. So I thought streaming is something which is very powerful, and there were already, you know, 50,000 stations even at that time, like Russia, BBC and everything. There are 50,000 streaming stations available online. So I said, why can't our Sindhi community can have a streaming station, and these same audio music and a lot more can be packaged together and it can be given as a radio station. So that's how I started radio station, first radio station in 2011. And it was like, you know,
massive
you know, it's kind of a revolution. I didn't knew even so many people used to send me the letter, you know, we have created this kind of a pamphlet and spread in all our panchayat members. People used to send, okay, we are forwarding this as a SMS with all our members.
Amazing.
They were super excited. So I said, you know, these songs were lying on the website and people were not downloading enough. But as a radio, it has become like, you know, it's a viral kind of a thing. Everybody is sharing and people like surprises. They like to, that is how they like to listen to the radio.
Why 7 radio stations?
When we started the radio with the first station, we used to have segments like 2 to 3 o'clock classic songs, at this time film music, at this time bhajan. So we had like, you know, different kind of the programs across the day. So many of the people, like, you know, people from New York will complain, you know, at 2 o'clock we are sleeping, how can we listen to your music? So can you do double timing, like in the morning time, in the night time, so that we can even listen to the music, like classic music. So, you know, one thing I realized in the software is it's so easy to double the things.
Right.
So you have one thing, you want to double copy the paste thing. It's copy paste. So I said, okay, if I can stream one station, what is the cost of streaming double station? It is not really 100% rise in the cost.
So Deepak shared with me ki when you are doing bhajiyas in a kadai and you are doing one share, you can just add something new. You can add some. For him, it is as simple as doing bhajiyas. You know, for him to open up a radio station is as effortless as frying bhajiyas. I mean, homemakers will resonate with you and. Yes.
You asked like, you know, how do you cover the cost of running so many stations?
So, because Deepak, you told me that this is community service. It's free.
Right. Yes, it's free.
You don't charge anything for it. So I was just wondering, how do you sustain your family? How do you sustain? But then I came to know that you do websites and you do a lot of other things. And this is just the one more extra bhajiya serving that you're giving.
So there are so many things technical I cannot explain to you. We have servers, we have websites, we have domains, we have apps. So it's like, you know, I'm in a simplistic fashion, I said, you know, what if I'm a bhajiya wala and I'm selling the bhajiya? So what if I just put up?
It's relatable to us, you know, and how many people can you reach out through a radio station? I want you to tell them the numbers because that's what matters nowadays, because whether you do a Facebook live, we've gone as high as 10,700 views for a particular live of ours. Mm-hmm. We're a very close-knit community of very quality-oriented entrepreneurs. But I get a lot of messages, and when I'm traveling, I get Gemini, Entrepreneur XL, live. So I've been like now connected so much with my community, and this is my way of giving back to women and children or people who can get information and add value to their lives. So Deepak, give us the numbers.
So we have like about 1 lakh listeners per month.
Wow.
On 7 stations. And then we get about 15 lakh minutes of listening every month. And it's not just the radio station, we also have YouTube channel where we are having 35,000 followers. We also record videos, cover the events, and then we push that on the YouTube. We have more than 50,000 followers on the Facebook. So it's, you know, nowadays it is not just like you can't be doing just one thing. Like I can be making only book, the alone book is not going to help you. So you need to add social aspect to it. You have to add so many things.
Entertainment.
So,
So the idea about Deepak sharing the numbers is he has a reach to so many people. Now it is his choice. What is he educating his community about? He can give entertainment, he can give education, he can share a cause. He can help people, he can do fundraising, he can anything, the sky is the limit.
So
the numbers,
the
right?
Whole idea is, you know, the internet invention is all about bringing two people together. It is about bringing
connecting.
Like you're bringing the driver is there, you want to travel, so you internet helps you to connect to the driver.
True.
It helps you to find out the nearest driver. So internet is all about connecting two people. So I felt, you know, internet is the right way to connect the Sindhi community, which is like they have spread all across the world and they don't know what is other Sindhi doing in other part of the globe. So this can be the mean in a very simplistic way. Can we connect them together? So like radio is one platform.
This is very heartwarming because our founder, Namrata Thakkar, she has got exactly the same emotion. Why not connect to people, support them to grow, raise their connectivity with the world and let them go and share what they want. So we as a core team, we are a lot of members in our core team. We have our expertise. Mm-hmm. So she said, Gemini, live. Okay, Kavita, events, this. So she has a CSR wing also, which is led by Beenasha. We are doing a toy drive where we collected tons of toys just by a community post and getting one live on section. So a small girl is donating toys across, you know, now people are connecting across Mumbai. So I think we have overrun the time.
Okay.
I just want to say each and every person, if you know a Sindhi, ask them to see this video and share, do a watch party. If you're not a Sindhi, think about opening a community radio station. Namrata, this is for you. He can get us all connected on a radio. Imagine just tuning into Namrata and listening to her. Hi, everybody. We are going to have an event tomorrow. We have a party tomorrow. We have a training tomorrow. We have a learning tomorrow. So Namrata keeps on giving us ideas and tickets to events. And I've been to IFA Awards. I just said, Namrata, mujhe jana hai. Next day, I get 2 tickets from her. So she's a giver and so are you. So I think we connect very well. And he's going to put in the links of the apps and the radio stations. You tune in and see, this is really different from the FM that you normally listen to.
Yeah, it's actually more powerful. Many people are actually switching from FM to streaming because it gives you so many possibilities, so many programs.
And if you have a question, please put it in the comment box and we'll answer it. Thank you, Deepak, for being with us.
Thank you so much. Thank you.